Hi, Derek the Beekeeper here. I want to talk to you about honey, and I've talked about this in another video, but I want to talk about why it's so important that your bees are not exposed to a number of different environmental factors and stressors that are causing them problems. So I always like to compare bees to humans, and in this way, if you consider yourself, your immune system is really important in your health. So if you have a very suppressed or problem with your immune system, you're going to have a whole host of different diseases you're susceptible to. So that being said, it's the same thing with bees. All these stressors and all these problems that people have with their food and wanting to buy organic and be natural and do all these different things, the bees are really the same way in a lot of ways. They like to go to sleep at night, essentially, is kind of what I call it, just like we do. They go in for the night and settle in. But on top of that similarity, they're also very, very similar with food. So they like to eat things that are not tampered with, not GMO stuff, not a bunch of pesticide-laden foods. And they also like to eat food that's really healthy for them. So you'll notice that they'll end up on soda cans and things like that, but that's not the best or ideal food for them, neither is for people either. So that being said, they naturally will go and get into flowers and other places where they can get that, essentially, that really, really good material for them to not only build from, but also to consume and to bring back to the hive for to basically go into the honey. So that being said, what's going into your honey is something to consider. Where the bees are. Are they on places where there's a bunch of different pesticides? Are they in places where there's a bunch of environmental stressors that are causing them problems? Because if that's the case, most likely all that stuff is getting transferred into your honey. Here's the next thing. A lot of beekeepers will turn around and use antibiotics because the bees are so weak from their problems they have that they're pumping in antibiotics to kill all these pests and things that are getting into their hives or these diseases that they're contracting and things like that. And the other thing beekeepers do on top of the different antibiotics and junk they give them is the food source. They'll turn around and they'll feed them super low quality food, which is not what they intended to have in the first place. It's like getting it's like drinking soda all day long instead of water. They're getting, you know, sugar water or some form of that. That's not their natural source of food or nutrition. So that being said, there are different videos on here where I'll talk about the good nutrition for bees. Essentially, think of it this way. If they are living out in the middle of nowhere, in the wild, what's the best food for them to eat? Well, it's going to be the natural things around them, and it's also going to be their own honey. So essentially, bees are going to live off that honey through the winter, and they're also going to use it as a food source, as well as the pollen and other things they feed the babies. So if you're interested in getting started in the process and having bees removed, go ahead and click the link below in the description, and we will be in touch with you soon.